Okay everyone, so in this quick video I'm going to show you how to create a scrolling text along with timer and your custom background on vMix. Okay, so I also done a video on the vMix digital title designer. In case you don't know how to use it, go ahead and check out that video. The link is in the description below. Go ahead and check it out and also learn how to use the vMix GT title designer. But that is not what we'll be talking about in this video. We're talking about how you can create the lower third, your scrolling lower third text, your timer, your background, and everything just like the one I make use of on my live broadcast. Okay, so without any further ado, let's jump right in to the video. The first thing you are going to do is go ahead and open the vMix software. Now, once you already open your vMix software, click on this three dot line here beside the overlay and select the GT title designer. Now open the vMix GT title designer and okay, so it's going to open. Now once it's already open, go back to vMix, click on the add input here. Once you click on the add input, go over to the title and SEML, and when you go over to GT ticker, you discover that the vMix have some lower third that you can use and just change the text on them. Okay, so I also did a video on how you can be able to change their background, so go ahead and watch that particular video. But in this video I'm going to show you how you can be able to design your own fancy looking one that you can use. Now click on timer and you can see all the timers we have on the screen. Now let's take note of this one, timer clock. Okay, close this, open the GT title designer, click on file here and go over to open. Now on open, click on the local disk from your PC and open the program files x86, which is the directory where the vMix is installed on. See here, the program file x86. Double click on it and scroll down till you see vMix. Not the vMix codec or the vMix social. All you're opening is the folder vMix. Double click on it, scroll down till you see titles. Now open the titles and go over to timer. Okay, so GT timer here. And can open any of the timer that you want. Timer center, and this is it. Okay, so this is the timer here on the screen. And let's push this timer aside. Let's reduce the size of the timer and just drop it one side here. Click on the rectangle here, drag this here, just use it, drag it all the way to the length, you know, how long you want your lower third to be. And once you've already done this, go over to style and you can select any of the style you want. If you want it to look like a box, just like this one, see the way this one is looking. If you want it to look like this, you can also do that as well. And once you're done, go home, click on the home button, click on colors, and you can use any background color that you want to make use of. Okay, now the thickness, remember to reduce the thickness to zero. We don't want any thickness on it at all. Now if you want it to be the square, click on this style again and leave it on square, and it's going to soon to see how it's going to look. So you can change it to anything you want. So I'm just going to go ahead and change the color back again, and let's remove this thickness. We don't want any thickness on it. Now once you're done, reduce the size very well and also click on the timer and reduce the size of the timer, and let's reduce the size of the timer to 72. Okay, so let's reduce it to 60 again, or let's reduce this the more to, okay, so 28, and let's reduce this one here. Can leave it as 36. I think 36 is okay. Now once you've already reduced the size of the timer, click on the rectangle again. See, click on that and just draw a small line. Go over to style and you can use any of this style here again. Now position it as the first, you know, the lineup from here, put it all the way here, and let's reduce this one a little. And let's change the color to white. Okay, so want the color to be on white. Once you've done that, use this this timer and put it on top of it. Now how do you put the timer? If you can see, the timer is at the back of it. On the timer, put your mouse on the timer, right click and go over to bring forward or send backward, and let's bring it to front. Okay, and you can see here it's now on the front of it. Now once you've already positioned it in front of it, the next thing that you're going to do, let's try to reduce this timer so that it can fit in on the screen. Now we're going to put it to 30, and you can see we already have our timer there on the screen. You can see how it's looking now. And once you really position your timer, click on this ticker here, and draw the line. You can see here. Once you've already drawn the line, go over to the font and choose any font you want to use for it. Now I have so many fonts, so many of them here, so you can just select any one and thought that you want to make use of. Okay, so I'm going to use this one here and place it at the center. Okay, and this is it here. Now make sure you change it to bold. You want it to be bold, and you also increase the size maybe to 48. And this is how. Now once you're done, click on the color and let's change the color to white. Once you already change the color to white, position it on the screen, and this is how it's looking here on the screen. You can see here, this is how you have those things. You can see, so all the way from here to here, and you can see how scrolling on the screen. You can see here, so this is how it's going to look like. So you can reduce the size, can increase the size, whichever one you want to do with it. And this is how it's going to look like. Keep ticking. See, we've created a ticker for ourselves. So we can use this to create any type of ticker that you want to use on vMix. If you don't want the one with timer, you can get rid of the timer and create your own custom one that you can add anything on top of it or anything at the bottom of it. Okay, that's it. So this is how I create my. Now once you're done, click on the file here and let's put save as. Now go over to any of your directory. It can be your document, download, and let's name it ticker one or ticker two. Okay, and save that. And we already saved it. Once you're done, minimize this, click on the add input on vMix. Now go over to the title and SAML, click on browse, go over to the directory where you save it on, and this is a ticker one. Open, select that. Okay, and this is how it's looking on the screen. You can see it here along with the timer. See, if you want to increase the size, double click on it and use the zoom to increase the size of it. You can see, use the zoom to increase and the pan y pan x. This one, bring it down a little bit. Okay, you can see how it's looking on the screen. If you don't like the timer, the way the timer it is on the screen, maybe the hour, the minute and the second, and you want to change it, all you have to do is to right click on the ticker and select title editor. Now select the title editor, go over to timer, see there, and click on clock. And then from here you can change it to any type you want. You see, you can change it to any type you want. From here again, you can change it, just change back and forth to any one you want to use. Okay, so see, now I've changed it to this one. It only has the hour and then the minute. You can see the way it is on the screen, and you can also increase the size as well. Go over to timer again, click on this plus button there, you can see, and that to increase it. You can see the way it's looking on the screen. On this place I added the timer. You can put social media handle and follow, you can put anything you want to put there. So all you have to do is just to make the white one, increase the white background, here. And can put your social media handle, how they can follow you. So as it's displaying there, this ticker is also scrolling as well for you. So whichever one you want to do, you can also do that as well. Okay, that is it. And see, this is how it's looking right here. Now the reason why I opened this, I went to the directory folder, is because I wanted to use the timer. Okay, I wanted to use this timer, that's why. But if you don't want to use the timer, just open it blank. Okay, open it blank, and once you've already opened it blank, click on this rectangle to draw your line. Instead of clicking on file and open, just draw your line. And from here, once you've already drawn your line, select your background, click on the ticker and draw your ticker here. And this is it, the ticker is already there as well. Click on color, change it to white, and this is how it's looking on the screen. Okay, so you can add anything you want to use. Click on the eclipse, draw your own, you know, your own circle sign, change it to white, position it here. So you can add your social media if you want them to follow you for more inquiry, anything you want to be on the circle, you can also put that as well. So while this one is ticking, whatever thing you want to add on the circle or wherever you want to add it, maybe from at the end part or at the beginning part, will also show as well. And once you're done, go ahead and save it. Okay, save it. And this is how to create your own custom lower third test sticker on vMix.